Greetings, Rob Simpson, SeattleHockeyInsider.com, VancouverHockeyInsider.com. John Hynes, ladies and gentlemen, head coach of the Minnesota Wild. How are you, Hynesy?
I'm doing great. Very good. Adjusting well and having fun.
Yeah, new gig. Exactly. I don't remember if Nashville you came in midstream.
I did.
You did?
Yeah, I came in Nashville very similar to this. It was a little later. It was January. Yep. January 7th, but very similar coming in midseason.
What's the hardest part?
I think it's really getting to know everybody. You know, it's when you come in, it's a moving train. So usually you're kind of coming in by yourself. So it's really the whole gamut. Really, it's the team and getting to know the players and kind of implementing some things that you want to do without changing too much to allow them to be able to play. It's getting to know your coaching staff and how you want to do things, the training staff. So it's, you know, it's real quality people here. So it's help, but it's a lot to try to keep up and make sure that you're, you know, doing the things that you want to do, but you're not disrupting people where they can't get their jobs done.
This is very serious talk, by the way. I just want to bring up the fact that a BC guy hired a BU guy.
So. Yeah, I know. I've heard that all the time, that the BC guy is the BU guy's employed by the BC guy, but we'll take it.
We'll take it. A lot of BU, by the way, lately. You got Mike Greer in San Jose. He hires Quinn, who's a BU guy. You got Drury, who's in, and these are teammates of yours from the mid-90s, Drury, right?
Drury, Mike Greer, yeah. Chris Kelleher, who's in director of play personnel here, was a year younger than me. Drury was a year younger than me. Mike Greer and I were roommates.
Right.
And then Quinny was a BU guy, but he's a little bit older. Mike Sullivan.
Mike Sullivan, how do you still have influence from Jackie Parker?
Yeah, I still talk to coach every now and then. I mean, he's a great guy to bounce ideas off of or just certain situations that you do. I know most of the guys that are in the NHL now, I think, keep a relationship with him for sure.
By the way, for a Minnesota audience, there's a statute of limitations, Geneva Convention. You're only allowed to, you can't talk about BCB,
that's right.
BCBU hockey for too long because people from the U, their heads explode.
Only Bobby Motzko would like that too much.
It's against the rules. Little bit of adjustment on the back end. Looks like Brodin's got a little surgery coming up, so you're going to be out for a while.
Yeah, he'll be out for a little bit.
But Brock Faber seems like, by the way, high school quarterback name, Brock Faber.
Yeah,
are you kidding
me? That's right.
Unbelievable so far.
He's been great. I mean, he's a great young guy. I think there's a maturity level about him that is impressive just to handle, you know, the NHL in general and the responsibilities he has on the ice. But, you know, his skating has been, I think it allows him to really get to the game that gives him a chance to be a really good player.
Yeah. Any recollection from previous experiences with the Seattle club?
You know what? Seattle, I think, is very similar. I think they're a well-coached team. I think they're a fast, tenacious team. They play strong defense. I think they like to get in on you and, you know, forecheck and get to their offensive zone game. That was the game that gave them the most success, I think, last year to make the playoff run that they've had. And from what I've seen, it's very similar.
Right. Last thing, you were a 5'9", 175-pound winger.
Yeah.
Mid-90s.
Mid-90s.
I wasn't NHL. You were considered undersized?
Undersized. Still 175 today, though, so that's good.
Oh, yeah. Attaboy. Hynesy, thanks.
All right. Thanks, Simmer. Appreciate it, bud.
Cheers.
Great to see you.